Hi, this is Engineer Rafi, and welcome to our online review. And today I will discuss about the volume of solid revolution. This volume is the volume generated by rotating a plane area to a certain axis. Okay. Like for example, we have a curve, and the given the equation of the curve. And like for example, at a certain boundary, okay, let's say x equals 10, okay, and we will find the volume generated by this area rotating about the x-axis, okay, rotating about the x-axis. Okay, so what will be the volume generated? So our formula here is volume that is equal to the area, okay, this area multiplied by 2 pi r, okay. This r, okay, this radius is the centroid, the location of the centroid from the x-axis, okay, or shall we call it bar y, okay. Previous video we already discussed about how to calculate the bar y and bar x of areas bounded by curves, okay. If you remember, that is area total bar x, that is equal to integral of x dA, okay, something like this. Area total bar y, that is integral of y over 2 dA, okay. This is for vertical strip, okay, vertical strip. Horizontal strip, that will be another formula also. Previous video we also discussed about how to calculate the area of this one, okay. The area would be equal to integral of x dy and the area integral of y dx, okay. x1 x2, this is y1 y2, okay. So now this is now a combination of these discussions. Let's have an example. Determine the volume generated by the area bounded by the curve x squared equals 4y. The line x equals 4 and the x-axis that rotates about the y-axis. Okay. So this curve is a parabola that opens upward, and the center is at 0, 0. And the line x equals 4, okay, that is positive 4, so maybe let's estimate it to be here. There is a point of intersection, x equals 4, okay. This point of intersection we can calculate as x squared is equal to 4y, then x equals 4, substitute 4 to the first equation, that will be 4 squared is equal to 4y, y is equal to 16 divided by 4, that is 4, okay, so x equals 4 and 4. Okay, determine the volume generated by the area bounded by the curve, the line and the x-axis, okay, so this is the area that rotates around y-axis, okay, y-axis, so it will rotate here. So what will be the volume generated? Okay, so from our formula, volume, that is equal to the area times 2 pi r, okay. This 2 pi r, that is derived from the Pappus theorem. For example, is a circular ring, okay, like a tire. And we want to calculate the volume of this. We take the cross section here to be circle, okay, the circle. We will take the area and then multiply it by, at the center, this will be our radius, okay. So this perimeter, that is the circumference, 2 pi r multiplied by the cross sectional area. So this is how the formula is derived. So our area here If we are dealing with the ellipse parabola, we can use the formula for spandrel of parabola and their area of parabola. Okay, the spandrel of parabola that is equal to the area is 1/3 of the base times the height. 1/3.
Sorry, and you can see it.
1/3. And that is equal to 1/3. Your base will be this one, and your height will be that one. So that is times 4. So 1/3, without integrating, the volume is 1 over 3 times 4 times 4. Okay, the volume is 5.33. The area is 5.33. Okay, this area. So volume will be 5.33 times 2 pi and r. Your r will be from the centroid, the location of the centroid, and the rotating axis. Okay, this will be our r, or we denote this before as bar x. Okay, bar x. This bar x, we can have the formula. This is our formula here. How far is the center? That is 0.30, and that is 0.75. Okay, 0.75 of x of b. So 0.75 of 4. Okay. That is the location of the centroid of this spandrel. 0.75. Okay. So 0.75 times 4 is 3. So times 3. Okay. So the volume now is 5.33 times 2 times shift pi times 3. 100.47 cubic units. Our answer is letter D. Okay. So no need for integration. If we are dealing with parabola, ellipse, we have formula for this one, circle. Okay. Only we use integration when the equation is a little bit complicated. Okay, next we have example number 2. The area bounded, the area enclosed by the ellipse 4x squared plus y plus 9y squared equals 36 is revolved around about the line x equals 3. What is the volume generated? Okay, so this is an ellipse that the center is at 0, 0. Okay.
You listen to a deep font of 5 feet.
Okay, let's try to draw it. The center is at 0, 0, and it revolves around line x equals 3. Maybe we don't know where is 3. Let's check first for the value of a and b. Okay, let's check first for the value of a and b. Okay, 4x squared plus 9y squared, that is equal to 36. Remember that our standard equation for ellipse, that is x squared over a squared plus y squared over b squared, that is equal to 1, and this is horizontal. Okay, and if this is x squared over b squared plus y squared over a squared equals 1, this is vertical ellipse. If this is x minus h, y minus h, that is the center is not at 0, 0. Okay, the center here is 0, 0. Okay, So let's solve this. 36, let's solve for the value of A and B. 36, 36, 4 divided by 36. Excuse me, you have 1 over 9. So 1 over 9, that is x squared over 9. Plus 9 divided by 36, you have 1/4. So this is y squared over 4. And this is equal to 1. Now this is a. If you, a this a is 3 and b is 2. Okay, so our assumption that this is horizontal, this is correct. Okay, because a is above x squared. So a equals 3, and the line is x equals 3. Okay. So x equals 3. Now, what the area enclosed by the ellipse is revolved about this line? What is the volume of? Okay, what is the volume generated when this area revolves around x equals 3? Okay, the area for an ellipse that is equal to pi AB, right? A pi times 3 times 2. So the area is pi times 3 times 2. We have 18.85 square units. So the volume generated, that is equal to the area 18.85 times area times 2 pi r. Okay. 2 times pi times r. Our r will be the centroid of the area. The distance from the centroid of the area to the line, that is 3. Okay, so the volume generated is 18.85 times 2 times shape pi times 355. We have 355, okay. 355.31. The answer is letter B. Okay. If the question is what is the volume generated by rotating this along its axis, along y axis, okay, this is y and this is x. First is the we need to take this area and our centroid will be this. This will be our bar. Considering this area half, okay, so divided by 2, this will be divided by 2 multiplied by this distance. This distance will be equal to 4 over 3 pi of a. 4 over 3 pi of a. Something like this. Okay, next. The area enclosed by the curve x squared plus y squared equals 25 is revolved about the line x minus 10 equals 0. Find the volume generated. This curve is a circle and the center is at 0, 0. Okay? Okay. Now we will compute for the radius. First, x squared plus y squared, that is equal to 25. So the radius is 5. Okay? This is taken from our standard equation of a circle. X squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. Okay, so square root of 25, that is 5. So this is 5, and it will revolve around x equals 10. Okay, x equals 10. X equals 10. So what is the volume generated by this circle rotating about x? equals 10. Okay, so we will take the area multiplied by, okay, so the volume will be equal to the area of the circle multiplied by 2 pi r. The area is pi r squared. Okay, our radius is 5, right? Pi r squared times 2 pi, our radius will be the distance from the centroid of the circle to the line of rotation. Okay, this one. So this is 10, okay, times 10. So the volume generated is, shape 5 times 5 squared times 2 times shape pi times 10. 4935. We have letter A. 4935. Okay. So as simple as that. If for example the problem is paraboloid. Like for example, this parabola, okay, and from this boundary, y equals 6, for example, 5. What is the volume generated rotating about its axis of symmetry, or the y-axis? What you will do here is, you take the area of this half. Okay, what is the area of the half? That is two-third base times height. Okay, this is your base and this is your height. Okay, from this point to that point, that is your base. And this is your height from the vertex to that point. Okay, after this one, you will multiply it by, okay, volume, that is equal to area times 2 pi r. Okay, your radius here will be the centroid of this area. Okay, the centroid of this area. Okay, the distance from this point, that is 0.60, and the distance of the centroid to the y-axis, that is 0.375 of b. Okay, this will be your r. Just remember that your r, that is always the location of the centroid to the distance of rotation. Okay, so that's all, and thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe and click bell button for you to be notified if we have new videos. Thank you for watching.